We're in downtown Montgomery on the steps of the capital of Alabama. I'm next to Pastor Jay Wolf, the pastor of First Baptist Church in Montgomery. And Pastor, Kay Ivey called upon you to help coordinate the promotion of Ribbons for Hope. Share what's on your heart.
Billy, I would be delighted to do so. Ribbons for Hope is a campaign. And the idea is it's a campaign to put a ribbon on a tree near your house, on your mailbox, on your door, maybe a fixture like a cross, perhaps at your work, anywhere you can come up with, put a ribbon out there. And the ribbon represents our prayers, our faith, our love for the Lord, our hope in Jesus Christ, our unity. And then that's all being sent to the first responders, to the medical people. That's being sent to the people who are in the battle zone. They need our encouragement right now. I'm particularly fond of this idea because my daughter is a nurse practitioner. My son-in-law is a policeman in Birmingham. So their calling from God is to risk their lives to save our lives. So we need to stand behind them. Plus, I believe these ribbons represent the hope of God. We know in the book of Genesis that after the flood, God put a rainbow in the sky, a rainbow of different colors, and these ribbons can be any color you want. And that rainbow represented God's hope and help after a time of crisis.
There are many people who are quarantined, but our hope is not quarantined.
Amen. There are a lot of churches that will not gather together for safety reasons for Easter, but Easter is not canceled. We've never needed it more. And I personally believe that God is going to bring from the valley of the virus a flooding awakening, a revival. I heard Brian Houston say on Rick Warren's Pastors Global Gathering and Prayer Conference yesterday that he senses in his spirit that the greatest spiritual harvest for the kingdom of all times could be starting Easter and in the season just beyond. We are seeing the Google searches for words like hope, faith, prayer, afterlife, Jesus Christ. They are soaring into the stratosphere. People are asking all of the right questions. Now, we've got to give them the Jesus answers.
You know, a lot of people are quarantined, as I said, on Faith Radio. We have people that are in prison that are listening. We have people in hospital rooms that are listening. We have people who are in nursing homes. People are alone. So I'm going to ask you to pray for those people and just lead us in prayer. This ribbon is a symbol of hope and for a reminder to pray. So let's pray.
Let's do, Billy. Oh, thank you. Dear Father, we come before you with a sense of humility. We come in faith. We know, Lord, that you not only hear us, but you answer. Lord, I thank you for what you're doing. You have humbled us. We have been freshly reminded of our humanity, our frailty, our mortality. Lord, we're in a tough spot. Not just here in Alabama, but the whole world is in a tough spot. And when we're knocked down on our back, it's easy to look up to you. And Father, that's what we need to do right now. Just look up to you. You tell us in 1 Peter 5 to cast our cares upon you because you care about us. You promise us in Romans 8 that nothing can separate us from your love. Your whole word says you win. You specialize in turning defeats into victories. So Lord, we not only give you COVID-19, but we give you ourselves, and we ask that you would transform any of our sense of being set back into your comeback. We know because of that empty tomb that you win, that you will take us by hand of faith, and you will guide us into a new place. Pray that you would defeat that virus, send it scampering back to hell, and yet at the same time use COVID-19 to spark a massive revival that will shrink the regions of Satan and build the kingdom of God. We ask for that in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Sousa Gang, you're part of what we did on the Ribbons of Hope here in the Capitol today. I'd love you to share what's on your heart.
Well, it's an honor to be here to join in prayer together with our beloved Governor Ivey and all of our leaders of the communities. And it's so important for us to be together praying for those who are actually fighting against the disease and to help those who are sick. So I think it's really important, not just for everyone else, but it is important for all of our internationals who are living in the state of Alabama, including, like myself, Korean families here. And this is my prayer. So I'm really thankful for the diversity that God has allowed in our state. So my prayer is that through this suffering, when we get out of this tunnel, We pray that we will be one, unified, and to keep glory to God, and also to help each other and to encourage each other. We can say that we overcome this crisis together. That's my prayer.
We're at the Capitol steps today, where Governor Ivey has just announced a campaign, Ribbons of Hope. I'm standing next to Joe Hancock. Joe, share what's on your heart about this day and this time of hope with these ribbons.
Well, I love the thought that our governor would lead in bringing the people of Alabama together in unity. That was absolutely tremendous. And then giving us a symbol to remember what this is a time. It is a time to have hope, but it is a time to look up. And it is a time to look up and say, Father God, what are you doing? God, always in the physical, wants you to point to the spiritual. And so we see what's happening in the physical. And she's given us a physical symbol of hope in the midst of this pandemic that we're in. But looking up, God doesn't want us to miss the spiritual message. And so that's where my heart is, that in the midst of this, we will truly hear the heartbeat of God, and that we'll be healed physically. But God will give us that opportunity that as we fall on our face, to be healed spiritually. And it always starts with repentance. It's always that same message. And so we've got to know what repentance is, what it looks like, and return to Father God. And I see God doing that. I've never seen or heard as much prayer going on as there is now. Prayer in the homes, prayers in the neighborhood, prayers right here on the state capitol. And it is amazing. But I believe it's just the beginning. It's just the beginning to look to heaven and say, God, show us our way. Show us our way.
That's Joe Hancock, His Vessel Ministry. She's taught many to pray, and as she's saying, she's seeing more people exercising their prayer life. We invite you to do that with these ribbons of hope as we pray for other Alabamians, particularly those on the front line.